Assalamualaikum. I am Dr. Nazia Hakim, Assistant Professor in Gyne Unit 1, DIMC Ocha Campus. This is your topic, this was your previous topic of the anatomy of the maternal pelvis and fetal skull. Today is your topic is normal labor, mechanism of the normal labor. But I just want to review the anatomy of the maternal pelvis and fetal skull, because if any students have missed this presentation, he or she cannot fully understand the mechanism of the normal labor. Okay, so I just go quickly for the anatomy of the maternal pelvis, not the detail. And as you know, the maternal pelvis or any pelvis is made up of the two innominate bones, two ilium, two ischium, two pubic bones, the sacrum, which is one bone, and the coccyx. Okay? Then you can see clearly on the picture, this is a cut section of the pubic bone. As you have seen in the picture, there is a two ilium, two pubic bone, and two ischial tuberous ischium bone in the middle of the two pubic bone joined to make a pubic symphysis, which is the main landmark of during the normal delivery. Behind the pelvis, there is a sacral bone, there is a sacral promontory, the ala of the sacrum, and the five sacral pieces, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And at the lowest level, there is a coccyx. So this is the ilium, this is the iliac crest, this is the anterior superior iliac spine, ischial coccyx, pubic bone, and pubic symphysis. This is just also for your reminder to review for previous anatomy. This is a cut section, okay? Then, the normal pelvis of the female pelvis are gynecoid maternal pelvis, which is the name of the gynecoid pelvis. The other are the pelvises are abnormal pelvises. So basically, we are concerned basically with the gynecoid pelvis, which is the normal female pelvis suitable for the normal delivery. The gynecoid pelvis is basically divided into three parts, inlet, cavity, and outlet. So we just go through for the boundaries of the inlet. So the boundaries of the inlet are anteriorly, there is the upper border of the pubic symphysis, lateral pubic bones, iliopectineal line, along the sacrum, and posteriorly, there is the promontory of the sacrum. And the diameters are fixed at the pelvic inlet in the gynecoid pelvis. The transverse diameter is 13.5 centimeter and the anterior posterior diameter is 11 centimeter, which is the fixed diameters in a gynecoid pelvis, and you have to remember all these diameters. Then we will go to the mid cavity. The boundaries of the mid cavities are anterior, upper side, middle part of the pubic symphysis, laterally pubic bones, obturator fascia, inner respect of the ischial bones, and posterior, they are the two and three pieces of the sacrum. The diameters are equal in pelvic cavity, which is transverse diameter is 12 centimeter and the AP diameter is 12 centimeter in a normal gynecoid pelvis. Then we will go quickly to the pelvic outlet, the lower part. The boundaries are anteriorly, lower margin of the pubic symphysis, lateral pubic bones, ischial tuberosity, posteriorly, last piece of the sacrum. And the diameters are reversed at pelvic outlet. Like the transverse diameter is 11 centimeter and anterior posterior diameter is 13.5 centimeter. So you have to remember the chat me if you can hear. So we were discussing the gynecoid pelvis. Hello. So we were discussing the gynecoid pelvis about the inlet, cavity, and outlet, and the diameters are transverse diameter at inlet is 13.5 and AP is 11, cavity is 12. And the outlet is reverse, transverse is 11, and the AP diameter is 13.5. So you can see in this picture, this is the transverse diameter and this is the AP diameter. Then the type of the pelvis. Normally, I am discussing the gynecoid pelvis. All diameters are within the normal for easy passage of the normally positioned fetus. The abnormal pelvises are android pelvis, the anthropoid pelvis, and the platyploid pelvis. Android pelvis is a male type of the pelvis in which the normal delivery cannot happen. So basically, we are concerned with the gynecoid pelvis. This is the platyploid. This is the android anthropoid pelvis. You should remember all the diameters of the gynecoid pelvis. Now, what is pelvic floor? So, pelvic floor basically this is formed by the two levatorinae muscles and fascia, two muscles made up of the musculofacial gutter pelvic floor during the second stage of the labor. That's important as you should understand what is pelvic floor. Pelvic floor basically is made up of the two levatorinae muscles, which is formed by long muscle band ref. What are the origin and how many muscles are inserted into the levatorinae muscle? Basically, levatorinae muscle is made up of the three muscles, the iliococcygeus, pubococcygeus, and iliorectalis. These three muscles will join to make a large one muscle, levatorinae muscle, which is the main support of the pelvis. In a pelvis, there is a bone, there is a muscle, there is a fascia, there is a ligaments and joints. So basically, the pelvic floor muscle is very important for the normal female. We will go for the perineal body. Perineal body, okay. The perineal body is condensation of the fibrous and muscular tissue between the vagina and the anus, formed by the bulbocavernous muscle, perineal muscles, and the fibers of the external sphincters. You can see the yellow one is a perineal body. Okay, this is the vulva, this is a urethra, this is a vagina. This behind the yellow one is a anal canal, and the red one is a ischiocavernous. The green one is a bulb. The blue one is a transverse perineum. So basically, this is the perineal body and perineal muscles. So we have reviewed the normal maternal pelvis, and then I am going quickly for the fetal skull. The fetal skull is made up of the walled face and base. There is a sutures line. I have taken my mic close. Okay, these are the sutures line on the wall formed by the individual bony plates of the skull and another. So you can see on a picture, this is a fetal skull. There are four bones. Basically, the front one is a frontal bone, the parietal bone, the occipital bone, and the temporal bone. These bones are joined at the suture line. What is suture line? Suture line basically is a membranous structure which is joining between the two muscles, two bones, fetal skull bones. What is the function of the sutures? Suture line means this can be compressed during the normal delivery to reduce the size of the fetal skull. So there are four sutures: sagittal suture, frontal suture, coronal suture, lambdoid sutures. Okay. And the junction of the various sutures, which is called the fontanelli. The anterior fontanelli is called the bregma, and the posterior fontanelli. The anterior fontanelli is a joining of the, you can see clearly on the picture. This is frontal bone. This is parietal bone. At the back is occipital bone. The two, between the two parietal bone, there is a sagittal suture, the frontal suture, and behind there's a lambdoid suture. So what is fontanelli? Fontanelli is a junction of the different suture line. So anterior fontanelli, which is called the bregma, is a junction of the sagittal suture, the frontal suture, and the coronal suture. It is large, big, and it is triangular in shape, diamond shape in shape. And the posteriorly, there is a small suture, which is a junction of the sagittal suture and lambdoid suture. It is small and triangular in shape. ओके, तो व्हाट इज द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ द फंटैनली ड्यूरिंग द लेबर बाय द वजाइनल एग्जामिनेशन फैसिलिटेट द करेक्ट डायग्नोसिस ऑफ फीटल हेड पोजीशन टू पेल्पेट द फंटैनली एंड फेवरेबल पोजीशन इज द ऑक्सिपिटो एंटीरियर पोजीशन. सो बेसिकली आई जस्ट क्विकली गो टू दिस टॉपिक because this was your previous topic and most of the students if they were present they can understand it, but I just reviewed for the new student who have joined first time in this presentation. So you should know the anatomy of the maternal pelvis, the fetal skull, so you can understand. So there is a different diameters of the head, and the diameters of the head will depend upon the flexion of the fetal head. Normally the head in the degree of the flexion and extension of the fetal head, normally the head is in a flex position. So first diameter will be in a well flex position is a suboccipital pragmatic diameter, which is 9.5 centimeter. It is started beneath the occiput to the center of the anterior fontanelli. And this is present in a flex attitude of the baby head. Like you can see in the picture, it is started 9.5 centimeter suboccipital pragmatic diameter, which is 9.5 centimeter at the lower end. It is started from the suboccipital pragmatic. Suboccipital means started from the beneath the occiput up to the pragma. Pragma is an anterior fontanelli. It is 9.5 centimeter, which is for the present in a well flexed head of the baby. So the baby can be delivered through the bony pelvis of the gynecoid. Then if the baby is further, there is a head is extension, less flex head or OP position, occipital posterior position, the diameter will be enlarged and it will be the suboccipital frontal diameter, which is 10 centimeter. Suboccipital frontal diameter, you can see in the left side of the picture, which is 10 centimeter, which means it is started from the occiput up to the frontum. It is 10 centimeter. It is present in a lex flex attitude of the head, which is the occipital posterior diameter position. Then the further deflection of the or partially extended head, the diameter will be enlarged, which is occipital frontal diameter, which is 11.5 centimeter. Then if the head is further flex, further extended, which is extended head, which is present in the blow presentation, the diameter will be enlarged, which is mento vertical diameter, which is 13 centimeter. The submento, mento vertical means menta. Menta means chin. It is started from the chin up to the maximum vertical point of the skull, which is 13 centimeter. As you, if you review the diameters of the pelvis, the 13 centimeter cannot be passes through the inlet, through the cavity, from the outlet. So the there will be the obstructed labor and the, you have to do the emergency cesarean section. Then if the further extension of the head, hyperextended head of the baby, there will be the submento pragmatic diameter, which is 9.5 centimeter. Submento means beneath the chin up to the pragma, and it can pass through the pelvis and a normal delivery can occur, but it is a phase presentation. So if you know the all the diameters of the fetal skull, if you can know the all the diameters of the fetal inlet, cavity, outlet, then you can understand ki how the normal delivery can occur. Okay, beta. Then now I am moving to the my topic is a labor. Labor. What is labor? What is the definition of the labor? Labor means delivery. So what will happen in a labor? Labor means that there is a regular painful uterine contraction. There will be the regular and painful uterine contraction, which causes the descent of the presenting part and the delivery of the fetus. And there will be the cervical dilatation. If the all things are happen simultaneously, then the labor can be going smoothly and baby can be delivered through vaginally. So before going to labor, you should know the lie, presentation, and position. What is lie? Fetal lie. The definition of the fetal lie is there is a relationship of the longitudinal axis of the fetus to the longitudinal axis of the maternal spine or maternal pelvis. Means on per abdominal, there is a relationship of the longitudinal axis of the fetus to the longitudinal axis of the maternal spine. So the normally the fetus in normal position is a longitudinal lie, mean in a straight direction. But if there is an abnormal lie, it is the transverse and it is oblique. So this is fetal lie. Then we will move to the fetal presentation. What do you mean by presentation? The part of the fetus which is occupies the lower pole of the uterus, or the part of the fetus which is present at the lower end of the pelvis. Normally there is cephalic or cephalic presentation, means head is normally present at the lower part of the uterus. The other than the head or cephalic is the abnormal presentation like breech. Breech means buttocks, shoulder, or a compound presentation. And then the third definition is fetal position. What is fetal position? Relationship of the bony fixed part on the presenting part in relation to the various quadrant of the pelvis. Like if there is a longitudinal lie and if there is a head, there is a vertex is the position, and in the pelvis there is a pubic symphysis. Like there normally there is an occipital anterior, means occiput of the head. Head in the vertex, the occiput is anterior to the pubic symphysis of the pelvic bone. So you should know the fetal lie, fetal presentation, and fetal position, and you have to show during the periabdominal examination ki what is the fetal lie, what is the presenting part, and what is the fetal position. Then we will go for the labor. So physiological process, as I have told you, physiological process that result in birth of the baby, delivery of the placenta, and signal for the lactation to the begin. So stages of the labor is divided into three: first stage, second stage, and third stage. And first stage is started from the onset of the labor pain up to the fully dilatation of the cervix, which is 10 centimeters. Normally the first stage is further divided into the active phase and the passive phase. What is active phase? Active phase is the onset of the labor pain up to the 4 centimeter dilatation. And the active phase, this was the passive phase. And the active phase is started from the 4 centimeter up to the full dilatation or 10 centimeter. Then the second stage of the labor, it is started from the full dilatation of the cervix up to the delivery of the fetus. And the third stage is from birth of the baby to the delivery of the placenta and membranes. So these are the three stages of the labor, and you have to understand ki which stage of the labor are you present. Okay, so for normal labor, there are three P's. This is the mnemonic 3P: power, passage, and passenger. So what is power? Power is a uterine contraction. If the uterus is contract and relax, then the labor will progress. So there is a power, which is known as a power. It has divided into the what is the duration of the labor pain, what is the strength of the labor pain, what is the intensity of the labor pain. Normally at the initial stage, the labor pain is the duration is small, like 5 seconds, 10 seconds. The intensity is mild, moderate, and severe. So the duration will be increases up to from 10 seconds to 20 seconds, 40 seconds. The maximum is the 50 to 60 seconds. And the intensity from mild pain to the moderate and up to the severe. So if the power is the good, the labor can be progressed smoothly. Then the second one is the passage. What is passage? Is a birth canal, is a pelvis, is a vagina. As I have told you, the normal gynecoid pelvis, if there is a normal gynecoid pelvis, then the labor can be progressed smoothly, which is favorable for the normal delivery. Then the third one is a passenger. Passenger is a baby. So it will also depend ki what is the size of the baby, what is the presentation of the fetus, and what is the position of the fetus. If the size of the baby, fetus is too big, like in a macrosomic baby, like in the diabetes, then there is a difficult delivery because the diameters of all the head will be increased. If there is a presentation, like if there is a not cephalic or head presentation, if there is a breech presentation, if there is a bra presentation, shoulder presentation, then the delivery cannot happen. And what is the position? If there is a head, but there is an occipital position, there is a bra position, then the delivery can be difficult. So for the normal labor, you have you there the three P's should be present: power, passage, passenger. If one thing is abnormal, the labor cannot be progressed smoothly. The labor can be happened on the non-progress of the labor, the obstructed labor. If there is no power, the labor cannot progress. If the passage is small, if there is no gynecoid pelvis, the baby cannot be delivered. If the abnormality in the fetus, like in size and passage position, then the labor cannot progress. So you have to monitor all the three P's. So now I am shifting to the basically my topic is not the management of the normal labor or the first stage of the labor. The topic is a mechanism of the labor. Mechanism of the labor, how the baby will be delivered. Ideally, this is basically a clinical posting topic. Ideally, you should be present in front of the pelvis and in front of the mannequin so you can easily understand what is the normal procedure of the normal labor. I just try to understand you ki how the labor progress clinically and theoretically. Hopefully, when you will join in a future in a ward, you can understand detail in a mannequin and a PDC. So mechanism of the labor. So we are concerned basically the second stage of the labor. When the baby is delivered, when the cervix is fully dilated and the baby is going to deliver. So it will happen in a second stage of the labor when there is a fully dilatation up to this birth of the baby. So this is the series of the changes in the position and attitude of the fetus or the birth canal. If all the three P's, power, passage and passengers are favorable, labor is likely to be normal. The relation of the fetal head and body to the pelvis changes as fetus descends. Beta, I will give you the answers at the end of the session. Okay, you just go through the presentation, then I will tell you. Okay, beta. Then, normally types of steps of the labor. How the labor started? The first step is engagement. What do you mean by engagement? Engagement means widest part of the presenting part enter into the pelvic inlet. Go back to the slides. What is pelvic inlet? What is the diameters of the pelvic inlet in a normal gynecoid pelvis? The transverse diameter is 13 centimeter and the AP diameter is 11.5 centimeter. So what do you mean by engagement? When the widest part of the presenting part, like head, when the three part of the pelvis of the head has been entered into the pelvic inlet, it is known as the engagement. Engagement. Number of the fifth of the head palpable abdominally. Normally, we divide the head per abdominally into five parts. This can be measured by finger method above the pubic symphysis. If the three part of the head has been entered into the pelvic cavity and only 2/5 part abdominally palpated, it is known that the head is engaged. Head has been entered into the pelvic inlet. So this is a good sign of the normal labor, that the normal labor is started and hopefully the labor will going progress well. Then the second step is descent. This all happened in a second stage of the labor, assuming that the first stage has been passed and now the patient is in the second stage of the labor. When there is a strong contraction, the patient has urged to push vaginally, the cervix has been fully dilated, the os is 10 centimeter, and you are going to deliver the baby through vaginally. Assume, make a picture in your mind. Then the second step is descent. Descent means downward. With the contraction, with the help of the contraction, spine contraction, the head is further descent into the pelvic cavity. It will occur during the first and second stage due to the uterine contraction and maternal effort. Okay? Descent is, it can be happened in the first stage of the labor. Engagement and descent is started in the first stage of the labor. With the progressive uterine contraction, the head is going to descend. With each contraction. Then the flexion. 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 What flexion? The head flexion. The baby head flexion. The head descend into the mid cavity. Flexion occurs. Means mid cavity. Where is the mid cavity? What are the diameters of the mid cavity? The both transverse and anterior posterior diameters are the same, which is 12 centimeter. Okay. So with the further contraction, with the further contraction, the head will going descend, and also it will going descend, and also the head will going flex. Okay. Further flexion of the head. Then the fourth one is an internal rotation, means the head will be going internally rotate up to the 180 degree. The normally circle is 360, the head going to rotate 160, at which is known as an internal rotation. What is internal rotation? In well-flexed head, occiput means head ka occiput enters into the pelvic girdle. Pelvic girdle is a pelvic diaphragm. Further rotation anteriorly, so sagittal suture line in the AP diameter at pelvic outlet. Have you remember what is pelvic diaphragm? The pelvic diaphragm is made up of the levator and eye muscle. Levator and eye muscle is a very strong muscle, is a large muscle which is made up of the pelvic floor. So what will happen? When the head had entered into the pelvic cavity, the head will be rotated, head will be strike on the levator and eye muscle on the pelvic diameter with a strong contraction. So head will be rotated 180 degree, and it will be, the body will be, your head will be in the anterior posterior diameter for delivery. Then the fourth one is the extension. Occiput beneath the pubic symphysis and brachma near the lower border of the sacrum. What will extension? In a well-flexed head, extend and occiput descend vulva. This is known as the crowning. What is crowning? Means now the baby is going to deliver. You are standing in front of the patient with fully scrubbed position. And crowning means when the head is distended, the whole vagina and vulva, and it will not recede back. Means now that there is an immediate delivery. So this is the crowning, and this will, the head is going to extension. Then the sixth one is a restitution. There is a sudden jerky movement of the head during the delivery, aligns with the shoulder and crosses the perineum. Means there is a sudden jerky movement, and the head will be going outside the vulva, and it will be visible outside the vulva and the perineum, and you are going to grab the head of the baby. This is called the restitution. Then the external rotation. The seventh part is the external rotation. Means the head is delivered, but the body is still in the pelvic cavity. You have to deliver the body. So what will happen? There is an internal rotation of the shoulders at the pelvic diaphragm. So it will be in the AP diameter. The head is delivered, but now the body is going to deliver in the anterior posterior diameter. So the shoulder will be rotated, internally rotated. It is known as the external rotation. So the question should be in your mind, all the things are going in the anterior posterior diameter at the time of the delivery. Why? Because at the pelvic outlet, the anterior posterior diameter is 13.5 centimeter and the transverse diameter is 11 centimeter. So now at the time of the delivery, when the baby is going out, the baby and the body has been in the rotated into AP diameter. So that's why there is an internal rotation, there is extension, and there is external rotation. Okay. Then at the last delivery of the body, first anterior shoulder deliver and then the posterior, and you have to gently upward traction of the entire body for the deliver, and then you have to clamp and cut the cord and hand over to the pediatrician. So this is basically the normal steps of the labor. You have to remember the labor is started from the engagement, the descent, the flexion, the internal rotation, the external, the restitution, and the external rotation, and the delivery of the baby. Sutures are membranous, allow bone to move together during labor. Bones are also compressible, known as the molding. Okay, what is molding? Molding means reduce the diameter of the fetal head, so there will be the easy delivery through the bony pelvis and prevent the brain damage. Okay, beta. So these are the basically the normal steps of the normal labor, which is occur occur in a normal gynecoid pelvis with the three power passage and passenger. If the contraction is good, the delivery will be going smoothly. If the passage like in the gynecoid pelvis, the diameters are all good, the delivery will be happen. If the baby is good, normal size, normal occipital anterior position, the baby will be going delivered. So I am just showing you the short video of the normal labor because I am unable to show you in a mannequin, in a PDC nowadays. So you can understand, this is a 1 or 2 minute video. You can see on the YouTube, and I am just going to share the link. Okay, just wait it now. Okay. All the students can see the video. Please feedback me. Normal labor. So you can understand how the labor occur, but you should know all the steps of the mechanism of the normal labor. First of all, you should know the anatomy of the maternal pelvis, fetal skull boundaries, and the normal position, attitude, and lie presentation, and what is the flexion, what is the extension, which diameter will be present in the flex position, which diameter will be flex in extended position. So you can easily understand the mechanism of the normal labor. I just try to understand you by this video and by this presentation. So any questions? Any questions, Peter? आवाज आ रही है मेरी? ओके बेटा, एनी क्वेश्चंस? कोई क्वेश्चन है आपके, बताइए, कोई चीज समझ नहीं आई है बोलिए. वार्ड आपके कब रिज्यूम होंगे? क्वेश्चन ये था कि अभी तक तो बेटा हमारे पास कोई ऐसा स्केड्यूल नहीं आया है. फ्रॉम 15 था, लेकिन अभी आपका थर्ड ईयर फोर्थ ईयर फाइनल का एसेस नहीं है कि कब से आप लोग ज्वाइनिंग है ना. डू यू हैव एनी नोटिफिकेशन फ्रॉम द कॉलेज फॉर ज्वाइनिंग? डू यू हैव? नो क्वेश्चंस? बेटा अगर कोई क्वेश्चन है तो बता दीजिए, तो I just finished my topic because this is a small topic. Basically, this is a clinical topic. And if anyone wants to ask me the questions, then.
Assalamu alaikum, ma'am.
Ji, walaikum assalam.
हाँ
मेरा तो लेक्चर एंड पर हो गया, इसलिए स्मॉल लेक्चर था और क्लिनिकल पोस्टिंग थी. बेसिकली कोई क्वेश्चंस भी नहीं आ रहे हैं, मैं तो पूछ रही हूँ लोगों से.
ठीक है
अब क्या करना है?
तो मैम ये कि आप 5 मिनट और वेट कर लेते हैं, अगर क्वेश्चंस आ
हाँ
जाते हैं
मैं
तो ठीक है, वेल एंड गुड, अगर नहीं आते तो फिर क्लास एंड कर लेते हैं. ठीक है मैम.
ठीक है, मैं 5 मिनट्स वेट कर लेती हूँ.
ओके मैम, थैंक यू सो मच. थैंक यू.